Ladies and gentlemen, the time has come for the bout you've all been waiting for, the heavyweight championship of the world. Please welcome the boxers as they make their way to the ring. First, introducing the challenger and number one contender from the United States, John Ruiz.
Well, Chelsea already big winners in Manchester today. Can the man from Chelsea, Massachusetts, make it a second away win in the day's second heavyweight confrontation? John Ruiz tonight bidding to become WBA heavyweight champion for a third time. And in that respect, he would be matching the likes of Muhammad Ali and Evander Holyfield in boxing history. Ruiz, an old-school hard man who's been around the top for 10 years now. He's won, lost and drawn in a trilogy with Evander Holyfield. He had Holyfield on the floor, amiable and dignified out of the ring, but in it, horrible to fight, very resilient, and knows how to score big wins in heavyweight title fights.
Yeah, Ruiz, he's never been exceptional in one department of the game. He's had to work hard to learn his trade, and he spent 18 years doing that. No glaring weaknesses in his style. He's not the quickest in the world, he's not the biggest puncher. But he's an all-round fighter, and he's hard as nails. He knows this is going to be his last chance. He's already a two-time champion. This would be a dream come true, and we know the call of the quiet man, but he'll be giving it everything tonight.
He likes to run to the ring, John Ruiz. He's 38 now, but he says he feels 28. And for his last couple of fights, maybe significantly, he's been weighing a lot less under new trainer Miguel Diaz, looking to shed the old ugly style that sometimes didn't win him too many popularity contests. He's been made very welcome in Manchester this week, but Hay is planning to end that warm welcome right here tonight. And maybe David Hay too, is a bit of a master of psychology. It's emerging, he's going to keep him waiting here. Champions, right?
Yeah, well, if you're a champion, you want to behave like a champion. Keep them waiting, and they're just building the tension. A tremendous atmosphere we have here tonight. This is going to be a fabulous night in British boxing.
Just gives the impression all the time, doesn't he, David Hay, that he loves this business at the moment. Nerveless, fearless, and just longing for the opportunity to strut his stuff in front of his home fans, having won the title away from home. But it's a big job tonight. And I think some people have maybe underestimated how big a job it could possibly turn into.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, here is the defending world champion from London,
Well, there's a fevered atmosphere in here as this 20,000 crowd watches these pictures beamed around the arena of the Haymakers' power, which has travelled up with him by the looks of things from the cruiserweight division. He intends to make John Ruiz feel that power tonight, maybe early on in the fight. There's the big punch that had Nikolai Valuev, the big Russian giant, tottering in Nuremberg as Hay won the WBA crown on a famous night. That was a hit-and-run raid, really, on a man 7 stones heavier. Tonight, I think, you'll see the return of the gunslinger. And still he keeps Ruiz waiting. A spectacular ring entrance for David Hay. Is this the new charismatic star which world heavyweight boxing has been crying out for? The division's been stagnating, but Hay's good looking, he's articulate, he's charismatic, he's been doing the celebrity whirl, he's become an A-list celebrity himself. All that goes out the window if he messes this one up.
Yeah, but I've always admired the way that he puts himself on the line. He's a warrior. He makes big promises, then he has to deliver on those big promises. And I think tonight he will want to look sensational. He's called out both of the Klitschkos already, and that's the fights we have to think about down the line. But he wants to do a job on Ruiz, because I think everybody accepts the fact that both of the Klitschkos would probably do a job on Ruiz. So if he wants to be in that bracket and convince us he has a realistic chance of beating those, then he has to do that similar job tonight. And I'm sure he's primed up to do that.
Well, he looks like he's sauntering out, doesn't he? To go around the shops, to buy himself a pair of jeans. Not turning up for a world heavyweight title fight.
That, he's just a showman. He loves every minute of this. I mean, look at the crowd, what a fantastic atmosphere we have here tonight.
And he's milking it for all it's worth. Pretty important for British boxing that Hay remains as a torchbearer at the top of the world power tonight. Here's the tale of the tape for tonight's big fight here in Manchester. David Hay is the younger man by 9 years. He's an inch taller. Tonight he only gives away 9 pounds, not 7 stones like he did last time. Reaches the same. Ruiz has been a pro now for 18 long years. He is very, very seasoned. But Hay is growing into this division now. And his knockout percentage is really impressive. 87%. If he hits you, you usually stay hit. There are the odds. Hay 7-1 on. Ruiz is 11-2 against on points. A lot of people might fancy that. Hay 5-2. Ruiz 20-1. If you think it might be a draw, 40-1. Here's Jimmy Lennon Jr., a world-famous MC, to make the introductions.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening to you and welcome to the MEN Arena here in the heart of Manchester, England, for the featured bout of the evening, brought to you by Adam Booth for Haymaker Boxing in association with Golden Boy Promotions and Sauerland Event, and presented live and exclusive by Sky Box Office HD. This bout is sanctioned by the World Boxing Association. The president is Gilberto Mendoza, supervisor Aurelio Fiengo, along with the British Boxing Board of Control. The steward in charge is Charles Giles. Our timekeepers at the bell and keeping count of the knockdowns tonight, Barry Pinder and Gary Grennan, and introducing to you our three judges scoring from ringside. From South Africa, Stanley Christodoulou. From the United States, Hubert Earl. And from Denmark, Ove Ovesen. And our third man to the ring, the referee in charge, hailing from Panama, Guillermo Perez. All right, fans, here we go with the main event of the evening. 12 rounds of boxing for the WBA Heavyweight Championship of the World. And now, ladies and gentlemen in attendance and boxing fans joining us around the world, live from Manchester, it's showtime! Introducing to you first, the challenger on my left, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing black trunks with white lettering and hailing from Chelsea, Massachusetts in the United States. He weighed in at 16 stone, 7 pounds. In a career that spans nearly 18 years, his record stands at 44 wins, 8 losses, and 1 draw, with 1 no contest and 30 wins coming by way of knockout. Tonight, in his 11th World Heavyweight Championship bout, he is currently ranked the number one contender. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the 2-time WBA Heavyweight Champion of the World, introducing John the Quiet Man Ruiz. And his opponent across the ring, the defending world champion on my right, fighting out of the red corner. Entering the ring wearing the colors of the Union Jack, he hails from Bermondsey, London, England. He weighed in at 15 stone, 12 pounds. With a record of 23 wins and 1 defeat, he has 21 big wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, here is the former Unified Cruiserweight World Champion, tonight making the first defense of his newly earned title. Please welcome the popular and hard-hitting WBA Heavyweight Champion of the World, introducing the Haymaker, David Hay!
An amazing reception for David Hay.
Once again, really taken in charge, up as a major star. Guillermo Perez, now to give instructions.
Referee from Panama.
Okay, wait, good fight. Okay, David, good fight. Chuckle went it.
Short and sweet. We're ready to go, and the first few minutes of this fight might be very instructive, because David Hay might be looking here to let John Ruiz feel his power. I must say, Ruiz looks all business, pacing up and down like a caged tiger beforehand. He's ready to go. And here we go. David Hay's first defense of his WBA heavyweight title. How much does Ruiz have left at the age of 38? Does he still have the drive and desire?
Well, he started well, Ruiz. He marched to the centre of the ring for the introductions. We reckoned he would go for this, and he's going for it early.
Oh, what a win! And down goes Ruiz. What a punch that is! In the opening half a minute from David Hay. There's the Haymaker. He's staggering. I'm not sure he knows completely where he is. Hay might take him out in one here. This so resilient man, who's only ever been stopped once, and that was 14 years ago, is in massive trouble. Another right hand round the back of the head, he says. But he's down again.
4, 5, 6.
He's not recovered, Reg. His eyes are all over the place. He's in bad shape. I think he's going to be warning him for punching behind the neck.
A rabbit
punch. At one point, he may also give Ruiz time to recover. No, he hasn't. That's good news for David Hay. Well, he actually should have done.
That might be crucial, but he did. It was a rabbit punch. But look at his power here. He's feeling the Hay power. If Hay wants to send a message round the world, he may be in the process of doing it. Not many people do this to John Ruiz. David Tua did back in 1996.
Ruiz's legs have gone. They're made of lead at the moment, so there'll be no punches in his punches. He can do pretty much as he pleases here. There won't be much coming back.
He'll do well to get through this opening round. More heavy shots. He's not missing, is he here? David Hay. He's shown John Ruiz very early just how hard he hits. Hard to believe this is an ex-cruiserweight. The power has travelled up with him.
Unbelievable power. That right hand that caused it, the first knockdown. Tremendous punch. That would have finished most heavyweight boxers. That shows you how tough Ruiz is. Will he get through this opening round? 45 seconds still to go. Incredible if he manages to do that.
Such an explosive start to the fight. How is Ruiz still there? He's been on the floor twice, but once from a rabbit punch. He's trying to get his gloves up. He needs to get through the first round. He comes back with a left hand. Maybe a little sign that the head is clearing.
Legs are still looking leaden. There's no movement. He started positively, but walked right on to a tremendous bomb. Ooh. Still going for it, though. What a warrior this man Ruiz is.
Tremendous pride, tremendous heart, Ruiz. He hasn't been a two-time WBA champion for nothing. He's the man who keeps bouncing back. But my goodness, Harry, he'll have to bounce back in this fight. He's starting to do it. Lands with the right hand and then punches after the bell. What an incident-packed opening round that was. Well, Hay announced himself in this fight with this right hand.
What a punch that was. I mean, he didn't even wind the punch up. He was actually moving back and drew Ruiz onto it. I'll be honest, the way he went down, I thought that was all over. It's a testament to this man's toughness. These were rabbit punches for the second knockdown. So the referee counted there, but he really shouldn't have done, because he should have warned Hay for the rabbit punch and given Ruiz time to recover. He didn't, which I thought would be crucial. But Ruiz managed to get himself through the round anyway, and that's the point deduction.
So Hay with a point off. The round would have normally been scored 10-7 because of two knockdowns, but the second knockdown was an illegal one, although it was counted, so unravel that one.
It shouldn't be called a knockdown if it was an illegal punch that caused it, but let's worry about that later.
That might be academic, the way this has started. Round two.
You would think Ruiz would have his hands up a little bit higher as he comes forward, but he wants this title, you can see that.
Now the word from Ruiz's training camp is that he's prepared long and hard and is absolutely cherry ripe. But he was caught cold by Hay's big right hand, but showed one or two signs towards the end of that last round that his head was beginning to clear. And Evander Holyfield said about him, he hits harder than you think, Ruiz.
And he's getting close to Hay and he's getting punches off now. We really felt this would be all over in the opening round. Tremendous that he managed to get him through that crisis.
And now he's beginning to come forward. Incredible, really, isn't it? Jolting jab from Hay. Who might even yet have to be involved in a long, hard, heavyweight night.
Well, he's pushing Hay back, trying to take some of the power away, but we've seen that Hay can deliver that power from any angle in any situation.
Oh, lovely right hand again. Ruiz took that. He was hurt by it, stunned by it, but he kept on ploughing forward. He's slow and he's ponderous, but he can drag you into an ugly quicksand of a fight if you let him, Ruiz.
Good movement from Hay there, though. Ruiz is more lumbering than usual because he still must be feeling the effects of those punches, particularly the right hand that landed about half a minute ago. It was a beauty.
Hay, younger, fresher, with the edge in power. We've seen it already. Can he make all that count? Well, this guy has been there so many times.
Well, if we questioned what would his desire be like at the age of 38, well, I think he's answered that question in fine style. Still trying to get close, trying to walk Hay down.
really did look as if it was going to be all over in round one. Ruiz has made a quite impressive recovery.
That in itself is down to the condition the man's in. You throw the effects of punches quicker if you're in the best of shape, and he must be in tremendous shape. He's been picked off as he comes forward, Ruiz, but as expected, hasn't stopped trying to get himself back into this.
Keep it clean, clean, clean.
All right.
Giving nothing away now. Give less away than you gave in that last round.
Cool.
Looking forward.
Well, that's... So another right hand there. That would have been a finisher with most heavyweights. Again, it's testament to how tough this guy is, that not only did he take that punch, but he continued to attack.
Round three. Worth remembering, this is only the fourth fight at heavyweight that David Haye has had, having been an undisputed champion at cruiserweight with that two-round demolition of Enzo Maccarinelli. Weighing the heaviest ever, 15 stone 12 pounds tonight. Ruiz working well with the jab and letting the right hand go. Good work there from this man who was the first Latino world heavyweight champion.
He has never been in with someone who's taken these shots full-blooded, still there and still coming back at him. This is something new for David Haye to cope with. Usually when he lands his best shots, I suppose you could say Carl Thompson, but that was a long time ago. So it's a long time since he had to cope with this. Good start from this round for Ruiz.
Great right hand again. Look at the speed of Haye. That's something else very much in his favour. He's kept his cruiserweight speed and his cruiserweight power.
And I think he's burst up Ruiz's nose. You can see the blood coming from the nose. That will no doubt affect his breathing. But the thing is, this man's so experienced, he won't let anything distract. Unless he lands that one big right hand that he simply cannot take.
I think you can see the level of determination that John Ruiz has brought to the argument tonight. Tremendous effort to get off the floor from that very first right hand. Great jabs by Haye tonight.
Yeah, he's timing the punches so well, getting the punches off then, getting himself back out of there, just waiting for the opportunities to unload the right hand again. Quality boxing, perfect tactics.
Just a little leer on the face of Haye. He always looks as if he's enjoying it in there, enjoying the battle, chance to pit his wits. This is what he dreamt of as long ago as an 8-year-old at school.
Ruiz not making so many mistakes now. I think that the power, I think even John Ruiz has to think, I can't take too many. Look at those
tremendous shots, combinations from Haye. Ruiz nods and gets on with it again. Some punches here that were taken down the walls of a city from Haye, but Ruiz is still there in front of him. He looks one of the fastest heavyweights since Ali, doesn't he, Haye?
Yeah, well, he's an athlete, he's a natural athlete. And as he's come up to the heavyweight division, he's kept that athleticism and tremendous power.
Good little burst from Ruiz right at the end of the round, but some eye-catching stuff from Haye in that round. Maybe just a bit of facial damage accruing. Certainly for Ruiz. Big jab on the nose, I think, caused that.
Yep, Ruiz taking everything that's coming his way and just marching right back up to the plate again. That's the shot that I reckon that could even have broken his nose. I think his nose has been broken before, but quite possible that one's done it again and it's bled ever since.
You can jab like that all night long, but you've got to believe me. You can jab like that all night long. Barrier, long, keep walking him into it. It's numbing him. It's numbing him badly. When you load up and roll underneath him.
Nice and still, shut your eye, Dave. Just shut your eye. Shut it.
Adam Booth, the main trainer, and that's Mick Williamson, who worked with Ricky Hatton, of course, on the cuts as well. back to work. Round four. Hay wanted to make a statement in the first three rounds. I think he did that. But he has to cope with the fact that psychologically he's thrown a lot of his best shots, but Ruiz still looks pretty strong.
You can't imagine he can continue to take these punches so cleanly. The thing is, he's getting close now and he's getting some punches off. And he never really been tested at heavyweight.
It's worth remembering that earlier on in his career, Ruiz, who got some of the right hand there, was down twice against Andrew Galotta, still won, got off the floor, won the fight.
But he is boxing so cleverly here, just keeping the right amount of space between himself and Ruiz, and Ruiz stretches with that jab in a position to counter.
Just waiting for him to make a mistake, cat and mouse almost. From Hay, look at him, just going backwards, keeping a range, and he's looking for fast punches once Ruiz commits himself. Like that. That's beautiful. Beautifully picked, that left hand.
Yeah, executing the plan perfectly. He's been told to use the jab. Just any opportunity to bring the right hand into play, but don't get drawn in to a war. This is just perfect boxing from here at the moment.
Just mixing it up, isn't he? Smart boxing and quick, powerful punches. Now Ruiz has got closer, lands with a right hand to the body in there. That's where Ruiz would like to get him, in the corners if he could.
Yeah, he's got to rough him up, but he can't pin him down. He should be walking across here as opposed to following him around the ring. He should be stepping to the side, trying to manoeuvre him, which you would imagine he would have learned in 18 years as a pro, but he's not. He's just following here around the ring.
The right hand from Ruiz, and another one too. Now he didn't get out of the way of that one. He was trapped on the ropes for that. Good work from the American-based heavyweight.
This is probably the best little spell Ruiz has had.
He's getting a bit closer, isn't he?
Yep, and getting punches home. His head movement is not good. When Ruiz gets close, he's been stepping out of range. A lot of punches landed from Ruiz in this round. Hey, good quality shots, but not an awful lot of them.
Gone a bit sleepy in this round. Ruiz has just outworked him, I think, in that session.
A bit nicer still, that boy. Take a deep breath.
It'll be a stamina test for Hay tonight as well.
Well, the fight is now becoming a little bit more grueling than most people expected, than most people thought, certainly after the opening round. Ruiz is getting close now, but not only that, he's finding the target as well. Hay breathing very, very heavily at the end of the round here. He must be in great shape, so out of breath is different from being tired, but I wonder, are doubts creeping in yet?
Hay's landed 54 to Ruiz's 38. Both of them headhunting by the look of that. It's worth remembering, John Ruiz in his career has beaten Haseem Rahman, Tony Tucker, Andrew Galotta, Jamil McClain, Fraser Kendo, Kirk Johnson. It's a good list of heavyweights of recent vintage. And of course, Evander Holyfield as well in one of their three fights.
Good right hand from Ruiz right at the start of the round. Well, as you can see, a man who is not easily discouraged. We wonder, did he come here for the pension job? No, he's here for the title. Lovely punching from here.
Oh, right hand, then left hand from Hay, sent the sweat spraying from the head of Ruiz. He can't cope with Hay's speed. There's another one. Terrific combination punching, then a body shot from David Hay, almost as if to say, feel this, how much of this do you want? Well, usually with Ruiz, the answer is he'll take any amount of it and argue with you all night long.
Well, Hay proving there that he can stand with a heavyweight. He has moved into the heavyweight division and he's grown into it.
Fascinating fight. Had a feeling that Ruiz was ready for a big battle here, and it looks that way. He's taken all of Hayes' punches. And he keeps on coming at you.
And nothing that he has done yet has discouraged him. Incredible fighter, John Ruiz.
Watch the use of the elbows. A little warning there for Ruiz from the referee. It's been a good fight this, though. Much more action already tonight than we saw in Nuremberg in that, well, chess match against Nikolai Valiyev.
Yeah, he found his rhythm again. Ruiz not getting as close, not getting so many punches off here. His jab working, his movement's working again. I just can't get the enthusiasm out of this fellow.
I have to say, Miguel Diaz, the new trainer for John Ruiz, has done a terrific job with him. He's letting his punches go much more in this phase of his career. None of the ugly mauling and holding we saw from him. He's trying to make this a fight, isn't he?
Yeah, the referee hasn't been involved. Part, I suppose, from the points deduction. But it's been good, free-flowing action here. He boxing really well again in this round.
And always with that blinding hand speed to help him. What he's got to be careful of is that he doesn't let the work rate drop and that Ruiz can then take over and win the battle of the jabs. That's what happened in the last round.
Well, Ruiz's pace has dropped a little bit too, as you would imagine. Getting the right hand home, Ruiz. The good roll from here. Love the shot!
And he's down again. He's claiming it's another rabbit punch. He's claiming it's a rabbit punch. That might be gamesmanship. It looked a good shot. Down for the third time in the fight. Up at seven, Ruiz.
Is that the punch that knocks the desire out of John Ruiz? Is that maybe just the last little bit away from him?
The bell has gone somewhere amid all of that. Nobody heard it. Jim didn't hear it. I didn't hear it. Only the crowd did. Luckily, the ref did.
Si no tiras vos, este casa porque él no tira nada. Si vos no tiras ya, tenés que tirar, tenés que disfrutar.
Well, just when Ruiz felt maybe he was getting a little foothold, that's what a champion does. Puts you on the seat of your pants. He complained, but he was already down before the rabbit punch landed. That was the punch that put him over. Okay, well, there was a punch landing behind the head, because that was because Ruiz was on his way to the floor. Tremendous stuff from David Hay.
Ruiz was saying in the build-up to this fight, in all honesty, America doesn't know or care about David Hay yet. I think he'll send a message to America if he stops Ruiz tonight.
Yeah, and this is exactly the kind of fight that we once seen over there. This is showing that he is a true heavyweight.
Round six on a dramatic night here at the MEN Arena, which has seen so many dramatic nights, like Ricky Hatton's coronation against Kostyasu, among many, many others. Calzaghe, Nigel Benn, Steve Collins, Nassim Hamed, they've all been here. It's Hayes' first fight in this city.
Ruiz trying to walk across here a little bit more now, trying to corner him, manoeuvre him.
Crowd bursting into song here. They're proud that they've got an English world heavyweight champion in David Hay. They want him to keep that title. They think he's in charge of this fight. But I tell you something, all the time Ruiz is in there, he's a danger. Oh, lovely right hand on the counter. Fantastic shot that was from Hay. Real class. Again, he claims a rabbit punch. Goes down for the fourth time. I think this is gamesmanship from Ruiz now. He's trying to get another point deducted and claim it's an illegal knockdown. But Hay, the hand speed and the power is getting it done for him here now. Hay's gum shield's come out in all of that.
I think it came out over in his own corner. He should maybe signal. We don't want his signal for the referee because he's one punch away here.
Really loading up with big, heavy jackhammer shots here now. David Haye. He wants to take Ruiz out of this argument once and for all. Referee steps in, the gum shield will be put back in. Crowd boo, I don't think they realise what happened. That gum shield had been out for quite a while. You had to do that. I think Ruiz is going to gamble now.
Well, I think he's been gambling all night long. He's never stopped coming forward, trying to come through the punches. He knows he can't outbox Haye. What a performance. Haye has been tremendous, but you can't give Ruiz anything but full credit for this effort.
Well, it looks like he's got over the most recent blitz as well, doesn't he? He's been on the floor here, John Ruiz. But he's going to keep on trying to take it to David Haye and hope that the Brit will run out of gas somehow. Another right hand. Blurring hand speed, Haye has. He's lightning and he's exciting.
Looking for the body as well now here. I mean, at 38, you would imagine Ruiz maybe not as tough around the midsection as he once was. He's pushing him back now, really taking control.
There goes the bell to end the round. Well, I'll tell you something, the Klitschko's maybe ahead of David Haye in the world rankings. He holds a WBA version, but there is no more exciting heavyweight to watch in world boxing than David Haye. I think that's beyond dispute.
Well, that's what we believed when he came into the heavyweight division. Tonight, he proves it. See, that was the shot, bang on the chin. And Ruiz turns away from the punches and then complains about rabbit punching. OK, the punches were not on target. That one was, and the knockdown punch was. And they weren't heavy punches anyway. I think he's just looking for things to complain about now, which obviously is a good sign.
Well, look at this, a 40% success rate in a heavyweight title fight. And that might not sound much to casual viewers who don't tune into boxing too often. Believe me, that's really high.
Now seven.
Into the second half of the fight. Haye's only gone beyond six rounds five times in his career. That's usually because the power has got his opponent out of there by that point.
His reflexes are so good, he hasn't taken a punch on the chin. He's been caught by shots, obviously, but never clearly on the chin. He just pulls away that split second early.
Apparently, from the Ruiz corner, the word was one more round. So are they preparing to pull him out of it? If he has that message, maybe he's really going to try to take it to Haye in this session to see if he can break him.
If Ruiz was a young fighter, I'd be thinking about pulling him out of there, because this could have a lasting effect for the rest of your career. But he's coming towards the end of his career. He may want to stick in there and just see it out. I don't know what his feelings are, but it wouldn't be a bad idea for the corner to pull him out.
Times in there tonight, Haye's looked like $1 million. Crowd are loving it too. But he hasn't completed the job yet. You just wonder, don't you, has Britain here got a successor to Lennox Lewis, who stayed around at the top despite a couple of defeats for a decade and then knew the right time to get out as well?
But he just keeping the reins where it should be, just at arm's length. Ruiz can't get close to mess him about, to drag him into a brawl. He's been picked off as he comes forward.
Setting little traps in there, isn't he, David Haye, for Ruiz. Oh, lovely right hand again, he can't get his head out the way. And wasting so little, David Haye here. It's as we hoped. The becoming champion has given him something else again.
Well, we knew he would want to put a show on tonight, and he couldn't have put on a better show. Tremendous.
Ruiz nailed him with a body shot in there, but he's quickly out of that corner. in the corners, on the ropes. That's not where Hay wants to be. On the outside, he's the boss with his speed. And there hasn't been one ugly John Ruiz more tonight.
I think he would have enjoyed making this, turning this into a maul or a brawl, but he hasn't allowed it because he's backed off out of there, not allowed him to make it messy.
Another cleverly devised strategy from Adam Booth, you'd have to say. They've worked long and hard, they've watched the tapes, they've come up with this, and they've stopped Ruiz doing what he likes to do. He's bossing the fight here, Hay. Well, they were threatening to pull him out after one more round, but they reckon he did well enough in that last session. There's Miguel Diaz on the left, been around boxing forever. Works corners all over the world. His professional career rather shorter than that of John Ruiz. He fought once as a pro, one win, and quit. Training was his game. And cuts, does the lot. Eighth round, here we go. Back out to work. David Hay with a big lead beyond dispute, with knockdowns accentuating his advantage still further. How much has been knocked out of Ruiz, do you think, Jim?
Well, there's no obvious signs that he's given up on it, but I mean, it shouldn't take too many punches like that. You would imagine if Hay just opened up with a combination of punches, put four, five, six punches together, maybe that would finish the job. He's pot shotting with real powerful single shots. I feel if he began putting them together, he could put an end to this.
Maybe he'll just wait in the way that Lennox Lewis always used to, till he feels he's softened up Ruiz sufficiently.
Well, I think he feels he can finish the job with one shot. That way he's not getting involved, not taking risks. So this is a sensible way to do it. And the crowd are loving every minute of it.
Well, Hay said in every interview in the build-up to this fight, he couldn't see Ruiz lasting the full 12 rounds with him. But I tell you something, Ruiz lasts the full 12 rounds with nearly everybody. Cracking right hand again, beautifully picked by a chopping right hand.
See, Hay not having to do too much work at the moment because Ruiz has just slowed down that little bit, not offering the same threat he was doing earlier. Good left hook from Hay.
Just bounced off the chin, didn't it, of Ruiz? How did he take that? Hardly blinked. Came back with something of his own. Lands with a right hand. Hay, quick to get himself out of trouble over there. Oh, what a big right hand. Again, Ruiz took that. That was a thunderous punch. That would have knocked down many a heavyweight.
We've seen a dozen finishing punches tonight that would have knocked out most heavyweights in the game. And Ruiz is still there, still coming forward. No praise too high for the effort this man's put in.
Well, he's made it a spectacular night out, I think, for all the fans who've paid to watch this fight. Wherever you may be watching, Hay promised fireworks. I think he's delivered. Speed again, a huge factor, as it's been in so many of the big, big fights of the last couple of years. David Hay puts another round in the bank. Some of his work tonight has been spectacular.
Yeah, all Ruiz is doing now is just carrying on with the job, trying to see it out. I wonder if he'll be thinking about pulling him out of there. It would be a wise decision. There are no signs he can get himself into this fight. He's taken some thunderous punches. His reputation is enhanced. It's well safe. He's earned his money. Wouldn't it be nice just to get him out of there? But he has his pride, and probably that's what's keeping him in there, keeping him going forward the way he's doing here, trying to make a fight of this.
Shut your eye, Dave. At the end, you shelled him and caught him with the right hand off him. Right. Believe in that style and mix the sharp moves up with it.
Sings out. Count no. time.
Not very close, that team. Adam Booth, David Hay. John Ruiz in the black trunks. Coming out again here for round nine. Of course, it's due to go 12. The World Heavyweight Championship, as recognised by the World Boxing Association, is on the line here.
I did think Ruiz would have been better at manoeuvring. Hey, I mean, he's just falling around again. You think he'd be walking from side to side, trying to back him into the corner, back him against the ropes. Lovely jab there from Hay. Hey, just too good for him in every department.
Just a bit marked up around the face, you'd understand that from John Ruiz now. He's like a tank, isn't he? He just trundles forward. He only has one gear.
Well, it's certainly not reverse, is it?
That's correct. He doesn't mind that, though. His battle plan has been spot on. He has to keep his concentration now.
Hey. First little sign that he thinks this could go the distance, and he's just popping the punches now. They probably let powerful shots go just sparingly now. The World Heavyweight title's at stake here. It's in the bag. Don't do anything silly.
Yeah, there's a professional job to do. This is the 11th heavyweight championship fight that Ruiz has fought. Previous 10, he's won 4, lost 4, one draw against Holyfield, and a no contest when he was actually beaten by James Toney, but then Toney failed a drug test afterwards. Speed has often beaten him before, Ruiz. Oh, tremendous punches. Right hand, then a left. He's in reverse this time, Ruiz. And they're going to put the towel in. It's over. David Hay is still the WBA heavyweight champion of the world. He's still reigning in Manchester. And tonight, he was sizzling. He sent out a message there that will reverberate around world boxing. Ruiz is stopped for only the second time in an 18-year pro career, and for the first time in 14 years.
Well, we reckon that David Hay would inject some life into a poor heavyweight division. He's certainly done that. He will be huge now.
There's his mum and dad. Look at that. Oh, how proud are they? The former Boy Scout, who used to knock out all the bullies around the Bermondsey area, he's still got that power, and John Ruiz doesn't half know it.
Well, David Hay proved everything tonight. Any lingering doubts that anyone could have had have gone. He is a true heavyweight champion. Tremendous performance.
There's his wife, Natasha, and they've got a little boy whose name is Cassius Hay. How about that?
Well, we can imagine who his hero is, but he is a hero tonight. Wise decision from the corner. They could have made that decision at any time over the last two or three rounds. No point allowing this to go further. These were hurtful punches. These are punches that could have a lasting effect. He's a 38-year-old man, given everything he had, no signs there were any hope he could get himself into this fight. Look at these punches bouncing off his head. Thankfully, Miguel Diaz had seen enough. There wasn't enough for a referee to stop the fight because he was still competitive, but thankfully Miguel Diaz decided enough was enough.
He was on the floor 4 times, once illegally from a rabbit punch, but Hay really, really shone here tonight. And I tell you something, there's going to be a queue a mile long, surely, to get on a fight between one of the Klitschko brothers and David Hay. There's the moment that Miguel Diaz waved the white towel. Enough. He's good, isn't he?
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the time. 2:01 in round number 9. Our referee in charge, Guillermo Perez, recognizes the corner and stops the contest. He is the winner by way of technical knockout, and still the WBA heavyweight champion of the world, the Haymaker, David.
Glenn McCrory, how impressive was that?
It was terrific, absolutely terrific. He proved tonight he's a genuine heavyweight, he's a genuine champion, and he deserves to be top of the heavyweight tree.
Has he sent out a message to the world there, Nicky Piper?
Well, you know, anybody watching that couldn't fail to be impressed by that performance. It was a brilliant performance, and he predicted a late stoppage. It was tactically perfect, he boxed beautifully, and I don't think we can really fault him in any way.
The towel was thrown in. It was right that it was thrown in at that stage.
It was so right. Davies started to beat him up. A wicked performance. Clever. Used his brain. Didn't just jump on him. Used the speed. Used the power. That big right hand over the top. Well, every time he hit Ruiz, he was in trouble.
And 20,000 go home thoroughly entertained.
Oh, well, what a crowd. They absolutely loved it. Lived every minute of it.
Let's hear from him ringside with Adam Smith.
David Haye, an emphatic, electric performance to defend your world heavyweight title. You also predicted the late stoppage. Did it go according to plan all the way?
No, not quite according to plan. I knew it was going to be tough. I knew when I did land my bombs, I'd hurt him, but I knew he's not the type of guy to get knocked spark out. You know, I punch pretty hard, but over the years he's developed a serious durability, and I knew it would go something like that. I didn't anticipate getting hit as much as I did during that fight, but credit to John Ruiz. You don't have that many fights in 11 world title fights if you get hit easily. And he's got a good offense as well. And, you know, everyone said John Ruiz wasn't an exciting fighter, but I believe I'm the most exciting heavyweight in the world. And even against John Ruiz, I can make it exciting.
Yeah, David Tua, the only man to stop him all those years ago. Looked like you would, though, in that first round. But what a chin. How durable was he?
He was durable. You know, I rushed my shots a little bit. Even when I was doing it, I knew I shouldn't have been doing what I was doing. I think I could have got him out in the first round if I'd have took my time. But, you know, he's an experienced guy, so I'll give him the credit. You know, training went well. I felt sharp. I felt fast. I didn't get the... I got cut in sparring about a month ago, so I had to stop my sparring quite early. It reopened from a little shot. But, you know, I didn't get the timing in the last two, three, sort of fourth and third week. But, you know, all credit to John Ruiz. I enjoyed the fight. I enjoyed the crowd. And at no stage in that fight did I feel like I was losing. You know, I got a couple of points taken off, hit him in the back of the head, which is quite fair enough. It was a bit of a cheap shot by me, but I know my adrenaline was pumping and I got the job done.
It looked like it with the speed and the jab, a successful homecoming. Where do we go from here? Can we tempt the Klitschko brothers into some unifications?
I think so. You've got to look at their last couple of opponents, pretty boring. Eddie Chambers came in looking grossly out of shape. You know, so did Chris Arreola the other day. Them guys, I think, are a disgrace to boxing. You need to come in like an athlete like myself, come in with speed, agility, you know, punch variety. I think I've got it all, and I just want to prove myself against the best guys.
Do you think you can take both of them out, the Klitschkos?
Definitely, no doubt about it. If I hit them with the same shots I was hitting John Ruiz, both of them two go over.
And a wonderful day for you, the Old Trafford crowd, and here tonight, new star here, David Haye.
One of the best days of my life, going out there in front of 70,000, you know, Manchester and London fans, all came together, all came in here unified, and sort of wanted to wish the British guy to retain his title. They did that without their help. I don't think the fight would have went as smoothly as it did, but I'm just happy, I'm just blessed, and you know, all I want to do is just keep entertaining these good people.
You have tonight. Well done, David. Enjoy it.